PvP honor items in the Burning Crusade cost quite a lot, and it will take a lot of time and effort to get them all, which is kind of by design as many of them won't be upgraded for about 6 months. They have different costs, different stats, some have gem slots while others don't, some slots have different alternatives that you can get relatively easy from other PvP events such as Hala and Terrakar Spirit Towers. Because of this, I came up with this priority list. The idea of the list is to build up your character piece by piece in a manner that you will get a lot of resilience and PvP related stats early as possible, so you get a bit tanky in PvP right from the start and already feel comfortable doing PvP while farming for the rest of the items. The list is based on 5 criteria: how good the item is, how much does it cost, so how easy it is to get, how customizable it is with gems or enchants, so what is its maximum stat potential, does it have a low cost, low stats alternative with resilience you can get from another event, and lastly, how much it will last, how long will it take you to replace that item. So let's get to the list. First thing first, the crowd control removing trinket. It is basically the most important item for general PvP for anyone, and it won't be replaced until much, much later. Also, it does not cost much. Second item to get would be the ring from the Terrakar Forest. Item itself is already pretty great, but the thing that pushes it to the top of the list is that it is really easy to get considering its stats. It just needs 50 spirit shards to buy, which you can get already by byproduct while doing dungeons. A normal difficulty Shadow Labs or Setagos dungeon will grant you 2 shards for each boss, while your faction controls the towers, and the ring will last you for a really long time, especially if you are a damage dealer. Next item is actually items, the blue shoulder and the hand, which you can get exchange for honor and marks. The items are quite cheap, considering the massive defensive benefits they bring as a duo. Firstly, besides the high base stats, shoulders have 2 gem slots, and can be enchanted with the powerful Aldor or Skyr enchants, which makes it give a lot of stats at the end. Also, its alternative is from Arena, which costs quite a bit and requires 2000 Arena rating. Gloves by itself can also be enchanted, and every hand slot item for each class gives special bonus that affects their abilities. What really brings them to the top of the priority though, it is the 2 set bonus, which is 35 resilience. You can get this bonus with any combination, but no other 2 slot will ever come close to these 2 when it comes to how much stats you get for how little honor and marks you will pay. Fourth item in the list will be the back item. It has great stats, it can be enchanted, pretty low cost, and it will last a very, very long time, as there is no new cloak in the season 2. You will just get it and forget about that slot for a long, long time. Next comes the wrist items. They are great items, cost is low, have gem slots, can be enchanted. Not much to argue here, and for some classes they can also be great for PvE too. Later comes the neck slot. The honor is not cheap, but only needs 10 marks, has really great stats and a gem slot. Following that comes the chest piece. It has 3 gem slots, good base stats, can be enchanted, does not really have an alternative other than the arena one, which costs a lot, but it has a big honor and mark cost, and that is the main reason it is on the lower spot on the list. Next on the priority list is the boots. They are great items, but they really cost a lot, have no gem slots, and enchants are alright, but not the biggest impact for the most of the classes, so it drops down a little bit on the list. Next, blue honor ring. Item itself is alright, but costs a lot of honor, no gem slots, and cannot be enchanted unless you're an enchanter yourself. It just needs 10 Alteric Valley marks, which puts it ahead of some other items. Next on the list is the belt. Belt item by itself is pretty great, but it cannot be enchanted, it has no gem slot, and it costs a lot. Also, you can get a belt from the Hala event that is much, much easier to get, which will make do until you can get the epic belt. Because of this, the honor belt is low in the priority when it comes to how to spend honor effectively. Even if the Hala event is not that easy on your server, I would still suggest you to try a bit to get the belt from there, as 20 battle tokens are really, really easy to get compared to massive honor and mark cost of the epic belt. Second from the last is the blue honor pants. Again, just like the belt, pens are good by themselves, and you get a powerful enchant on them. But they cost a lot, and you have a lower set alternative that basically gives you the same resilience, plus a gem slot, which you can get from Hala. If Hala pens are not possible, then you may increase the priority of these pens between the chest and boots, or try to get the arena pens first. Last on the list is the blue head slot item, which you can get with honor. It has a really big potential with meta slot and enchants, but it costs really a lot, and there is a much easier to get alternative from the tarot card, which only costs 18 spirit shards. 18 shards literally means only 2 Shadow Lab runs and one more boss from Shadow Labs or Setacles. The alternative have pretty low stats compared to honor one, but when it comes to priority, the massive cost difference between the two brings it to the bottom of the list for me. The ideal route to jumpstart your PvP defenses would be the pants and belt from the Nagrand, helm and ring from the tarot card, trinket, hands, shoulders, cloak and braces from the honor items vendor. When you get these items, you will gather about 184 resilience without any enchants or gems. Using the low cost to low stat alternatives will save you about 58,000 honor, 30 Altoric Valley, 40 Arete Basin and 30 Warsong marks compared to just getting the honor items. There you go. Remember that priority can change depending on how you want to play the game, which class you play, if you have some marks more than others, or maybe you have a good arena rating that enables you to get some items from the arena, or even that you have some amazing PvE items that you do not care for the resilience from that slot. After all, itemization guides are rather just suggestions more than set of rules. If you like this video and want to help the channel out, please subscribe to the channel. Thanks for watching and have a good one.